Om Agyana Timurandasya Gyanandana Salakya Shakshuran Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah Sri Chaitanya Manobhavastam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Svayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svaparantikam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So the world is celebrating Christmas. The devotees have been celebrating Mokshada Ekadasi, the Gita Jayanti, and they're chanting the whole Bhagavad Gita and things like that in one day. Huh? Some have chanted all the Sanskrit and the translations. Others have chanted only the translations, or some have chanted only the Sanskrit. Whatever, it all acts, right? I myself, I have not done anything major like that. Also don't have so much energy to do all that at the moment. But we are meditating. We're meditating on that verse, or these verses in the Chaitanya Charitamrita that describe the illiterate Brahmana who was not able to read, but who had received the order from his spiritual master that he should daily read the Bhagavad Gita. So he would sit down and would just read that Gita, although he couldn't read, but act as if he was reading. And then people were laughing at him. But then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu one day asked and said, "So, why you're sitting there reading Bhagavad Gita and you're crying? Huh? I see that you are crying." And he said, "I'm crying because when I think that Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, became the chariot driver for his devotee, and that he becomes the servant of his devotee," he said, "that makes me cry." Lord Chaitanya said, "You are the greatest expert on the Bhagavad Gita." So so this is very deep, because first, the entire Bhagavad Gita is about to bring Arjuna to the point to finally surrender and do what Krishna wants. So in other words, to become a devotee. And then we see that actually beyond that is Krishna, who is the, beyond all the words that are spoken, there is Krishna, who is actually the servant of his devotee. And that is, of course, that is bhakti. Bhakti consists of, or has its roots in the bhaj dhatu, the Sanskrit root, bhaj, which means worship, love, and service. Where is worship? When worship is done without love, then it's just done out of duty or out of fear. Out of fear, we worship because we think, if I don't worship, what's going to happen to me? That is fear. But worship done out of love, that is interesting. And love is not just sentiment. Oh, I love you so much. I love you to death. That's very nice, but what are you doing about it, right? You just stand there, I love you, I love you, I love you. No, we want to see some service. So therefore, Bhaj Dhatu, worship, love, and service. So it is said the first six chapters of the Bhagavad Gita are giving us the introduction. It gives us the principles of yoga. It gives us the principles of Aham Brahmasmi, that we are eternal spirit souls. Najayate Mriyateva Kadachin. It gives us also the struggle that we have to overcome lust. Avitam jnanametena yoginam nichavairina kamarupena kuntiya duspurena nalena cha. It gives us that the fact that lust is what causes the covering of our consciousness. Then we get the various types of yoga, karma yoga, jnana yoga, jhana yoga, right? Or meditation, knowledge, karma yoga, our activities connected with Krishna. So all these things may be there. But then the six middle chapters, the first six chapters at end with yoginam apisarve san matkatein antaratmana shalavan bhajate yomam sami yuktatamam ataha, that of all yogis, he who worships me with love and faith is the greatest. And then start the six middle chapters, and that is where bhakti is described. And of course, that is our interest, bhakti. We just, what else is there? And the nice thing about bhakti is that bhakti is dedicated to Krishna, and attaining Krishna, that is the greatest award. So there's nothing more to attain after we attain Krishna. We just want Krishna. We just want service to Krishna. We don't want anything else from bhakti. So this is really very nice. Mundane worship is worship where we worship and then we want something else. We approach Krishna and we say, oh, give me health, give me wealth, give me power, give me so many things. That is not pure bhakti. That is karma misra bhakti. That is devotional service mixed with a personal agenda, with a desire to obtain fruits of our activities. Jnana yoga, yes, where we are worshiping Krishna because we want liberation from birth and death. So we're not worshiping Krishna out of love. We want something from Krishna. We want liberation from birth and death. So this jnana yoga. Then we have, we finally come to pure devotional service. Maya shakti manaparta yogi union madasrayaha samsyan samagramam yatagya jasi tatshrinu. Yes, tatshrinu. Just hear about Krishna. That is our desire. Yes. So the this is the nature of to somehow or other just be a devotee, right? What else are we going to be? We are all here, different individuals at of a different age, different place, so many, and some of us are studying, right? And we're studying to become something. We're studying engineering, or we're studying economics, or whatever we're studying. We're studying to attain something. But all that, what's the meaning? We're just simply wanting to be devotees, and that's the best. Right? And the more we can live like a devotee, the nicer it is, the nicer life is. It depends what we have already done before Krishna consciousness. If before Krishna consciousness, we established our life in such a way that we became established in the world and professionals, yes, then it is natural that we will utilize these skills. But once we are devotees, once we've taken up Krishna consciousness, how much shall we endeavor for material things? It's like sometimes I think, you know, I could have been many things, undoubtedly, right? I could have, what if I would have, instead of being temple president in Vrindavan, I would have joined the 24-hour kirtan many years ago. Oh, then now I would be so much better, you know, because then I would have been full time into music, which is what really, I would have liked to do that, but it wasn't. But the Vaishnavas asked me to do other things, so I did. And yes, I could have been a scholar, right? I mean, a serious scholar. I could have been. I have that inclination, you know, to really like go into scripture or certain aspects of our tradition and just kind of dig it out. But that also didn't happen. It could have been so many things. I could have played piano, but that didn't happen, you know. I could have been a sportsman when I was younger, not anymore now, you know, but I could have been. I was a good swimmer in school. I could do I could swim underwater the full length of a swimming pool. So I was proud of it too, but still it showed that I had some condition, you know, I could do these things. Yeah. Yes, I could have gone into so many things. What is the point? What I could have been. Sometimes we have these days, what I could have been. Dream. Yes, what I could have been, what I could have done with my life. But really, if we really think about it, we're actually right now doing the best thing one can possibly do with our life, because it's serving Krishna. And all other things, yes, sometimes our mind goes, oh, what I could have been, what I could have done. But then in the end, say, but actually giving my life to Krishna is the best. That is the best. That really makes it meaningful. That makes it nice. everything else, and then everything else goes on, right? According to our age, you know, there's in the Bible, of course, you have Ecclesiastics, right? Decided to write about it, and it sort of brought back our remembrance of it, you know. And in Ecclesiastics, the speaker of that particular part of the Bible, he keeps on saying there is a time. There's a time for everything. There's a time. So if I apply that to all of you, there's a time to study. There's a time to work. There's a time to eat. There's a time to sleep. Or maybe there's a time to make socks. There's a time, at least Sukhyanti is knitting. There's a time for everything. There's a time. And one has to just, so on the material level, we have to do our part, you know. Just have to do a part according to the time, and that just goes on. But that's not so important. What's really important is Krishna and what we can do for Krishna. That is what we really care about. And that's what it means to be a devotee. Krishna, the priority. First Krishna. And then so many other things. Yes. So, what else is on my mind? I don't know. It's like I'm struggling a little this week. I'm a bit exhausted and so on. So, dragging through the week and having a busy week also, let's see. But that's also there. There's a time. Time to be exhausted. Time, there's a time. And one has to just accept the time. The time has a direction. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Yudhisthira is all disturbed because of the great battle at Kurukshetra, and 640 million people have been killed, and Yudhisthira feels very bad about it. And he comes before Bhishma Dev, and Bhishma Dev just explains that, my dear Yudhisthira, it is the direction of the time. What are we going to do about it? Time cooks up some destiny, and then what you're going to do about it? You have to just act according to the destiny as it unfolds. And there's not much else that we can do. And we are all in our situation. We all feel caught in this, in the current pandemic situation, but we were already caught before. We were already caught in the material world. We were already caught in a material body. We were already caught in karma, right? You know, by your karma, you'll only get so much or too much. By karma, you don't know. So, yes, our karma is controlling things. So what can we do? We just are locked in a destiny. Yes, we're locked into a destiny. And it's like, we're not in control. We can just, as we are basically going down the road of destiny, we can make some adjustments. You know, we can decide whether we want a green sweater or a pink sweater or whatever, you know, a purple one. That we can choose, maybe. Well, at least whatever is available in the shop, right? Yeah, because even that's not our choice. You go into the shop and there are a few varieties and you have to choose one, right? That's the one thing I hate about shopping. I know ladies love shopping, and I myself, I hate shopping. And I'll tell you why I hate shopping, right? Because I have an idea in my mind of what I want. And then I go looking for it, and I can't find it, right? It's just impossible to find it. And that's why I hate shopping, because in the end, I have to choose something that sort of comes close to my idea, but it's not really what I had in mind. But okay, I settle for the compromise. I guess whereas ladies have the other approach from, well, let's have a look, what is there? You never know, you know, there might be something nice. Check out this, oh, look at that, look at this, look at that. So it's a different approach, but a man has an idea in his head of what he wants. And then he goes looking in the shop and he can't find it. Oh, it's too much. That's why we hate shopping, most of us. There are exceptions. Whatever, you know. So yeah, online shopping is maybe easier, you know. But then again, you can't have it in your hands. You can't check it out. Of course, you can send it back. And that's also going on. Yeah. But whatever may be, these are all the things that just come and go as part of this material world. These are not the real things. The real things are really, it's about Krishna. It's about when we chant, it's about when we read, it's about when we do some service for Krishna. That's when it's really happening. That's when we are really on the cutting edge. The question is not to be or not to be. The question is to serve or not to serve. Okay? That is the question. Yes. And that is what we are somehow or other doing. We are, yeah, it's sort of Christmas and all that, and that the end of the year is near, right? And so, you know, it's the reflective time, the time we sort of think, well, what about this year? And it was, of course, a strange year. If I think about it, I just, maybe this year, well, I don't know how many flights I took this year, but very, very few. Sometimes I stand on the ground and I see a plane going over and I go, I used to fly on those. But it was good for me to stay on the ground for a year, to face the seasons instead of like having like, I don't know, you know, like a little bit of winter, a little bit of summer, a little bit of everything, a mix, a total mix, but never actually living with the seasons. So this is awkward. So yes, in that way, it's been good. It was nice. But on the other hand, I still want to go back to my old life. You know, and to connect with everyone, okay? Because that, making a connection with devotees and people around the world who show some interest in Krishna consciousness, That is my real life. That is the juice. That's what my life is about. And to somehow or other make it realistic, make it fun, make it something that we want to do, spiritual life. And yes, so these Zooms are also for that that purpose. This is the second Zoom today, and so at one point I'm going to Zoom out. I don't know how long I'll Zoom tonight. Maybe not super, super long, but yes, I will Zoom for a little longer. Sorry, I'm just scratching my ear. It sometimes misbehaves. Okay, let me see who is there. So, yes. Yeah, like I used to go to England all the time, right? And because it's just very close. But now England seems so far away, right? I mean, seeing people from London, and London, it might as well be on the moon, you know? It's like, I feel like I'm speaking to people who are in a space shuttle, and it's like called London. I mean, London is just as far as Australia these days, right? So distances have changed, right? And yeah, it's on Zoom that we are sort of looking at each other for a short moment, and then we go back into our own life. Yeah. So I find that all, what shall I say? It is, karma is such a thing that it, karma reduces us, right? When we get karmic reactions, and they limit us. Just like now, the whole world is limited. So karmic reactions, they limit us. And yes, so, and then that limitation of being limited, that forces us to reflect and to develop a different mood. So somehow or other, this is what Krishna wants from us. He wants us to reflect. We don't really want to, at least not anymore. After kind of 1 year, we feel it was enough. Now let's get back into action. No more, not so much reflection anymore. But let's see. It may be a bit more. And yeah, it's nothing we can do. So yeah, it is a time where we have to accept. Yeah, Krishna makes us, but it's yeah, what can you do, in life? So many things happen. It's like, I'm looking at all the names here on the screen, and of course I know many things about your lives, and I know what you went through and so on, and so many times situation, nothing could be done. We have to accept. Yeah, so that is there. One has to accept and just take shelter of the transcendental platform. That is the Bhagavad Gita. That was Arjuna's position, or Yudhisthira after 640 million people were killed. Yudhisthira had to accept the direction of the time. There was nothing he could do. He just had to accept this. Yes. So that is interesting. That is the difficulty, in that we don't want to accept. Yeah. And we always want to change our destiny. Say, no, no, we want to change our destiny. Now, okay, this tendency of wanting to change our destiny, we can link that with Krishna, right? And just take up different services for Krishna. And in that way, it becomes Krishna conscious and will become uplifted. But it's not so easy. It's not so easy. Sometimes the mind is rebelling. So yeah, that's the year. I am. Still struggling a little with this after effects of the COVID, you know. It's like, destiny, yeah? I have to take it and make the adjustments. Just have to adjust and carry on, as I had to adjust so many times in my life. I don't know if I will achieve all the things I want to achieve in my life. I think about that sometimes. And of course, a spiritual master wants to achieve things through his disciples. That's how the spiritual master is spreading his influence. Just like Vishwanath Chakravarti. He was influential in a chakra, in a circle. And it's like Chakravarti means one who had a very great circle of influence. Yes. So Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur had a very great circle of influence. And yes, we are thinking about that, you know. So my circle of influence is through you, right? And what you can do. Yeah. And Nadia Mani should go and rest, because she also had COVID and was in the hospital. You look tired, go rest. Huh? Yeah. Yeah. So we are so the reflection part, okay, or the reflection part of the talk is now over. And, you know, how much can we reflect, you know? How much can I watch the seasons? You know, I looked out of the window and I saw the leaves come on the tree. I saw the leaves fall off the tree. I saw like the winter setting in. The branches freeze, all these things, and go like, okay, if I keep on watching trees, I'm going to become a tree, you know? So, and then I'm looking at people who have a poster of trees behind their head. So it's like trees everywhere. Gosh, I never understood this part of the Bhagavatam about the prachetas. You know, they had been meditating, and then for a long, long time, and then they came out of their meditation, and then they saw that the whole earth was overgrown with trees, and they became very angry. And with their mystic power, with their eyes, they start to burn the trees. But now it's coming a little closer to me, these kind of feelings, right? It's like just the same old trees. Gosh, you know. Okay. So I got myself a vehicle, you know, because there ain't no flying. So got myself some wheels so that with these wheels I can move around and meet some people, some different ones, you know, than the same ones, right? And face to face, because I should have antibodies now, so that's okay, you know. So in this way, on Sunday, I'll go to Amsterdam and just spend some time there, you know, doing a few programs. And then, yeah, I guess we'll go back into Germany, and because it's bigger, and there are more devotees there, and which is also nice. But yeah, everything is pretty closed, you know, because whenever there's a meeting in a temple, then it's reserved people only so much places and this and that, you know. You can't just have an open house these days, right? So what to do? What to do? But at least do something, right? The question what to do, well, do something, right? Do something or do something, right? Yes, let's do something. You know, I think so. And that is very nice. It's like one thing I appreciated is Vaisheshika, because we had a little Zoom a few days ago, but that he in the middle of this year, he decides that he wants to do 2 million Bhagavad Gitas. Now it's a huge number, and he's trying to develop a plan so that the whole world, that all of the ISKCON world can distribute 2 million Bhagavad Gitas. Well, I don't know what the number will be in the end, but of course India is a giant and in this regards, and there are other places. And some places are making very humble contributions. But I must say, it's bold. It's pretty bold to get such an idea in the pandemic year, because most people in the pandemic year are sort of thinking, well, you know, let me grow a cabbage in a pot in my room under a hot light or something like that, you know? I mean, what you gonna do, right? It's like, let's water the geraniums, you know, something exciting, right? Yeah. So, shrunken world, right? A lot of people, their world has shrunk, become very small. Yes, little world. But this is, and then someone in the middle of all that thinks really big, starts thinking, I'm going to do 2 million Gitas. I mean, it's impressive. So that's what impressed me, that in this year he thought like that, you know, because it's a year where everyone is sort of, okay, everyone, it's getting smaller. But no, he decided to... it's going to do 2 million Gitas. So it's very interesting that positive response to the situation. And that's an interesting thing. I also try in my way, you know, like I was sick, and then I just, after a few weeks, I declared I'm better. Okay. Of course, I wasn't fully better, but I just declared that I was better, because by declaring that I'm better, I start to feel better. You know, when you keep on saying, I'm sick, I'm really sick, I'm still sick, I'm so sick, you become sick of yourself, you know, and everyone else gets sick of you too. So it's better to just say, I'm better, right? Everyone said, oh, great, you're better. And it makes you feel better too, right? So I always use this technique, you know, so therefore people always say, wow, you just bounce back up so quickly. One day you're really sick, and then a few weeks later, you're completely better. Well, you know, I mean, completely is a bit exaggerated, but it's nice like that. You know, so I like that approach, the positive approach, and also to do something. So let us do something. So now once I come in Germany, I'm going to visit people. Yeah, that's my plan. So in the new year, I'll start, you know, and don't be surprised if you suddenly get a call and say, well, I'm getting close, and within 3 days, I'm there, you know. Just sort of, I'm warning you, Germany, I'm coming. Right. And then there are so many other places that are still all closed and borders closed and so on. So they will have to wait. What can I do? But a bit later, we'll fix that. You know, we'll go there too. See what we can do. Yes. And of course, you know, I'm waiting for the opportunity when we can meet again in person. And yeah, you know, like big gatherings. Right. So it's nice when the devotees from everywhere would come for a Vyasa Puja. We had devotees from Australia who joined in. We had devotees from everywhere who joined in. And it was lots of fun. Just that everyone comes together and is together and so on. Yeah, so that will come. That time will come. Yeah. But every situation, Krishna is always the objective. In every situation, it is about Krishna. Yes, sometimes we have conversations about so many topics, and today someone was talking about astrology and saying that according to the astrology, he would have an arranged marriage. I said, okay. Yeah. And that's all right, right? As long as she's a devotee. Okay. As long as she's a devotee, the marriage can be arranged. But as long as she's a devotee. Otherwise, what's the point of it? If some marriage is arranged to a non-devotee, that's not a good marriage. Of course, then you can try to make the non-devotee a devotee. And that's a mission. That's definitely a mission. I did make my former wife a devotee, you know, like... because I knew we were from before Krishna consciousness. And it took a little time, you know. It took a little effort. But I saw the devotee in her. And I knew that she would be, that she would take it. I knew that. Yes. And so this is the point. We can't really make devotees. We can discover the devotee in someone and bring out the devotee, because that's what scripture says. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhu Kabunai Sravanari Sudha Chitta Karyo Udai. It says we can awaken what's already there. We cannot just make someone a devotee. We meet some demon and make him a devotee. It's like, no, the demon is already a devotee. Okay, here's, now someone starts to, there's 21 things on the chat. So let me have a quick look at what's there on the chat. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. And to all my dear God brothers and God sisters. And we had our first World Gita Day program too. That's Tirumala, who is part of the BBT Africa, but also a Pan Africa, by the way, and who is also involved with Vaisheshika and all kinds of things. Maharaj, how can one advance from being attached to fruits to doing for Krishna? Well, offer the fruits to Krishna and then you can eat them. It's okay if you like fruits, but you have to offer them to Krishna first. Whatever the fruits are. Yes. From this stage, karma misra bhakti to purer type of devotional service. We are not the doer. Let's just be busy in devotional service. And if we have some personal desire, that's okay. Krishna will purify us. See? Sarva dharmam paricheyamam ekam saranam vraja aham tvam sarva papebhyo moksha isyami masucha. Just abandon all varieties of activities. Just take up devotional service to me, and then I will deliver you from all these reactions of karma and so on. I will liberate you from these things. Where's the switch? Devotional service is the switch. So just apply ourselves to devotional service. That is the switch, and it will happen. Radhivinod, I have to ask a question that I want to ask aloud. Radhivinod, there you go. Ask. Unmute yourself and ask. Yes.
Hi, Krishna Maharaj.
Hi, Bo.
So earlier on, you mentioned that we should worship out of love and do service. Otherwise, we'd be worshiping out of duty. But I feel like when I'm chanting, I'm doing it out of duty. So how do we worship out of love if we have no love?
Well, you know, if we have no love and we do it out of duty, that's also good. It's a good duty. Yeah? It's called Vaidhi Bhakti, or devotional service out of duty and according to rules and regulations. And that is the beginning. It is said by doing that devotional service, Vaidhi Bhakti, according to rules and regulations, we gradually develop spontaneous devotional service. So it can, and that's where love is born, right? So it's very good. Good duty, nice duty, actually. Huh? Yeah, so now we do many things out of duty in Krishna consciousness, and that duty is elevating us. And so there's nothing, we can't force it, right? Love cannot be forced. It cannot force our heart. Hey, heart, start loving. It doesn't work like that. It has to naturally grow. Right? So now let us serve out, chant out of duty, serve out of duty, everything. Yeah, that is nice because it's a transcendental duty. So it's good.
So I shouldn't have to feel guilty for doing that.
No, 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 no. Rather, you are glorious because you have dedicated yourself to a glorious duty. Yeah, you are glorious.
Thank you, Guru Raj.
Yeah. Yeah, it's very nice that you've taken this chanting so serious, that you've made it your duty. That is wonderful. And Krishna will also see like that. Krishna will get, you know, tears in his eyes when he will see, oh, here is Radha Vinod. And look, she made this chanting her duty. How wonderful. How wonderful. She chants my name and she does it faithfully. That is wonderful. Wonderful. So Krishna must be thinking, Radha Vinod is wonderful. And I'm also thinking.
I'm going to have tears in my eyes.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to have tears in my eyes, not only Krishna.
Yeah, that's okay.
Thank you.
Thank you also. Now, this is Divya Gita. Thanks for mercy yesterday. I really felt that I got the mercy. Gurudev, this is Divya Gita again. I have a guilt about material things I could achieve in life and still want to achieve to do more service if. Yeah, you know, there's things we want to achieve and we can use for Krishna if Krishna gives them to us. And some things he will give and some things he will not give. But you try. You can try to do many things. That's okay. And see what Krishna gives. Okay, Hare Krishna Guru words. It's time to look after yourself by taking rest in caps. All right, thank you. Thank you, Mom. Could you give a little insight into how the Maha Mantra correlates to the meeting and separation of Radha and Krishna daily in Goloka? Jeez. I've only heard about this once in a lecture and not much detail were given. And what does it mean to cultivate a mood of separation from Krishna as followers of Rupa Goswami? I don't know this. I think what you're asking, could you give a little insight in how the Maha Mantra correlates to the meeting and separation of Radha Krishna daily in Goloka? I think that's something you have to experience. I don't think that's something that should be explained in a lot of detail. And I think if we first chant out of duty, then later we will start to feel attachment to Krishna. And once there's attachment to Krishna, then we start to feel also a little separation from Krishna. And when that separation, when that attachment to Krishna is growing, then that separation will increase our attachment, and then eventually we'll come to nista, we'll come to ruchi, we'll get firm determination, taste, deep attachment, ecstasy, and who knows, love of God. And then we'll understand how the chanting correlates to the meeting and separation of Radha and Krishna daily in Goloka. What does it mean to cultivate a mood of separation from Krishna as followers of Rupa Goswami? No, it's not what we try to cultivate. We don't try to cultivate a mood of separation. That we're trying to create a mood of service to Krishna. And then later, love comes. And when love comes, then automatically separation is there. Where there's love, there's eagerness to be with the person we love. So then, when we are not with the person we love, we feel separation. That will be there. But that's not our meditation. I want this separation. No, our meditation is I want to serve. I want to increase my eagerness to serve. That is our meditation. Somehow or other, let me serve now so that I can become more enthusiastic to serve. So our meditation is very much, I want to be a servant. Sukhayanti. It is said that we have free will. I hear Jayadvaita Maharaj say once that the only free will we have is to decide whether to be a devotee or not. But I have a doubt. For example, did Dhritarashtra, Duryodhana and such really have a free will? If they would have chosen to become a devotee, the Bhagavad Gita would not have been spoken. Krishna's purpose would not have been fulfilled. So how did they have free will really? They had to act the way they did in order to allow Krishna's pastimes to happen the way they did. No. Krishna just takes advantage. Krishna takes advantage of our misused independence because he's very expert. So it wasn't that they were forced to act like that, but Krishna just took advantage and used them. Krishna, for example, when Duryodhana came to the palace of the Pandavas, that was built by Maya Danava because Arjuna had saved him from the Arjuna had protected him. And then the thing is, he had built this palace for Arjuna and for the Pandavas, and there were optic illusions. So there was water in the building, and it was very hard to figure out. There were mirrors or something. Where was the land? Where was the water? And Duryodhana got bewildered, and by accident, he stepped right into the water and fell into the water. And all the ladies were laughing. And Duryodhana, on the expression of his face, it was too much. And Krishna was there, but he didn't do anything to stop the ladies from laughing. Right? He didn't intervene at all. And this reinforced the envy in Duryodhana. So Krishna was using it. Krishna was maybe manipulating it, but it's not that Duryodhana didn't have that free will. The point is this, is that in terms of free will, we are always under the laws of karma. And karma looks like we can manipulate a little. We can decide which side of the street we want to walk on, the sunny side or the rainy side of the street. Yes, that we can choose. But then the rain may go to the other side of the street. And, or to our side of the street, and the sun may go to the other side of the street. We can't control it, right? So we're not in control, and it's just all happening. So we're making choices, but these so-called choices are not really choices because nothing is under our control, and we are just being pushed along by greater forces. Of karma. So the so-called choices on the material plane are not really choices. Then the choice to be a devotee or not, yes, that is the real choice. That is where our free will kicks in. We can voluntarily surrender to Krishna or not. And Duryodhana didn't want it. Krishna never forced him to be like that. No. There would have been someone else. If Duryodhana would have stepped out, maybe Karna would have played that role because after all, we have this, everyone has his own destiny, and Duryodhana was an envious person. And Karna, also there was a problem with karma. Karna. In the Mahabharata, there's a situation where it says that Duryodhana was the result of the yajna that the daityas, the demons, had performed, and that he then appeared as Duryodhana, and that Karna in his previous life was Narakasura. So certainly had a karmic destiny, but they had their independence. They could surrender, they could have surrendered to Krishna. Right? They had that chance anytime. Okay. Divya Gita. Again, it was a type mistake earlier. Not if it was Krishna conscious. Gurudev, it is karma when we're not able to achieve what we want. It hurts me. Yes, what can we do? It is karma or Krishna. It is like that. Yes. We are limited in the material world, fundamentally limited. Right? Our original spiritual bodies are now covered by a limited material body, and we're living in a limited house with limited people in a limited street, and we can eat only limited amounts, and we get only limited happiness, and we have only limited time. Everything is limited in the material world. What can we do? Yeah. Zoltan says, we are on Alcatraz, Maharaj, the UK version. Okay, a jail, locked in, yeah. We are locked in this material body, and the bars of the jail are sex desire. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. Ich hätte eine Frage auf Deutsch. Wird Eker Chakradam frei bleiben von den Einflüssen des Kali Yuga, ähnlich wie Navadvip Dham? Hat Srila Prabhupada so etwas irgendwo erwähnt? So the question translated is that will Eker Chakradam remain free from the influence of Kali, just like Navadvip Dham? Did Srila Prabhupada explain something like that? Srila Prabhupada didn't directly talk about that, but it is the abode of Lord Nityananda, where Lord Nityananda appeared. So it is a transcendental place, and therefore it is not affected by the material energy. The only thing that happens in these dhams is that it is covered by a layer of the illusory energy. And the layer of illusory energy is there just to hide the transcendental dham from the non-devotees. And in that layer, we do see the influence of Kali, but the actual dham is never affected. So it is the layer that's affected. Just like when Krishna was 5,000 years ago in Vrindavan, it was different than the Vrindavan that we see now when we travel there. And when we travel there, there were no... There was no pollution, no auto rickshaw. The Yamuna was completely clean, and now it's all different. What we see, Yamuna is not clean. So much noise pollution, so many people, so many buildings, so many things. This is the layer that covers the dham. So each dham has a little layer of illusory energy on top to hide it from the non-devotees. And there we see the influence of Kali Yuga, but on a deeper level, those who can see beyond will actually see that the Dham is eternal, and that it is just, unaffected by anything of the three modes of material nature. Ich hoffe, dass es klar war. Ich kann es noch kurz wiederholen auf Deutsch, dass der heilige Dham ist immer bedeckt durch Yoga Maya. Und diese Bedeckung macht es unmöglich für die Nicht-Vaishnavas, um die wesentliche Natur von der Dham zu erkennen, zu anerkennen. Wir können dann nur durch Bhakti, durch diese Bedeckung hingehen und dann können wir darunter der heilige Dham entdecken. Eka Chakra, das Geburtsort von Nityananda, ist ähnlich so wie jeder andere Dham, weil der allerhöchste Persönlichkeit Gottes ist dort erschienen. Dann gibt es wieder diese Stufen da oben, die den heiligen Dham bedeckt hat. Und das ist dann natürlich, seht aus, dass es doch beeinflusst ist von Kali Yuga. Aber das ist nur die äußere Bedeckung. Darunter ist der ewig heilige Dham und der ist niemals bedeckt worden durch diese materielle Kali Yuga Einfluss. Vielen Dank, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and Sri Vrindavana Thakur, Chaitanya Bhagavat, there are a few instances that I have read so far where he indicates that in future Srila Vyasadeva will reveal more pastimes, more detail. What is Sri Vrindavana Thakur referring to? Has Srila Vrindavana Das already revealed this in another text, or is it something that is still to happen in the future? Thank you for having this weekly Zoom session with us. It's happening right now and it's happening in the future. The Prabhupada Lila Amrita is also part of that. And we are here on Zoom and you are all here being recorded for people in the future to see all the tilak on your faces, and they'll all say, it's a miracle. Look at all these people. They all have tilak and yours is very bright. So that is very good. So yes, sometimes I have said it, we are in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. We are in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya. It hasn't ended 500 years ago. It's still going on and we are part of it. So as the Vaishnavas are writing about all these things, as the mercy of Lord Chaitanya is unfolding, right? Then that is how these things will be revealed. Yes. So more will be written about the amazing nature of the movement of Lord Chaitanya and how the mercy of Lord Chaitanya spread everywhere. If one is practicing Krishna consciousness in an artificial way, what benefit do they receive, and would they eventually overcome the stage of being artificial? Yes, it means that we still have some other motive. Like in the Nectar of Devotion, we discussed that Gajendra had a desire to become liberated from material distress. Of course, he had a reason for that because there was a crocodile hanging on his leg. Dhruva Maharaj, he wanted material wealth greater than his father and grandfather. Grandfather was Lord Brahma, so that was quite a bit of wealth. So Dhruva was motivated, had a material motivation. Then the sages of Naimisaranya were inquisitive. And finally, the four Kumaras were wise. They were not interested in the material body or enjoying sense gratification. And they knew that they were eternal spirit souls. So they were the best. They were the closest. And for them, it was easy to just take up devotional service. Beni Madhavi Devi Dasi, will you be coming to France, please? Merci beaucoup. Vous êtes très gentil. Oui, oui, oui. On arrête un petit peu, hein? Mais on regarde qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire. For the time being, we'll wait a bit, but, as things progress, as borders open, as lockdowns are sort of out of the way, and things get a bit more natural. It's not only COVID, but it's also all this crazy lockdown that is just too much. Yeah? So if France will not be so locked down, then I can consider La France. And Nature, and of course, also, hopefully to see you in Kirtan Island, Mauritius, soon. Yes, thank you for that. Yeah, it's a nice place. Then Anand Josi, we are also waiting for your association to meet you in person again and again. And we're waiting for that time. That is America in New Jersey. And we meet in New York and in Jersey. Yes, I'm looking forward to that and what to do. Nadia Mani, it's very sad that I cannot come to Amsterdam to meet you personally. Yeah, I will speak on WhatsApp what to do. Dear Maharaj, regarding the trees in India and Africa, there's a tree called mesquite, prosopis juliflora, which is also known as the devil tree. Oy, oy, oy. This is a very invasive tree that damages the land and it spreads everywhere while overtaking local species. After seeing the activities, this tree species, I thought of the prachetas. Yes, and the prachetas saw that the whole earth was overgrown with trees. And that's not meant to be. There's also meant to be land for agriculture and all these things. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, Anand. And now, Suba is completely healthy again. I hope so. Yeah.
Yeah, Guru Maharaj. Dandavat pranam, Jai Srila Prabhupada. Getting better, getting better and better day by day by your blessings.
Oh, very good. Very
yeah. Almost there, almost there.
Yeah. Very good.
Thank you.
We don't make devotees, we discover devotees in someone. Brilliant. Yeah, that's Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhu Kabunai. Srila Prabhupada said something like that because in relation to Priti Vityachi Yatanagaradi Gram Sarvata Pacharo Hoi Vimoranam, in every town and village, my holy name will be chanted. Prabhupada said in relation to that, that therefore, this verse means that there are devotees in every town and village. So Prabhupada basically said the devotees are already there. Because it said, everywhere my holy name will be chanted, so the devotees are there. And we have to only find them. Okay, Hare Krishna Maharaj, happy Gita Jayanti and happy Christmas. Please take more rest and good nourishment, which may be difficult on travel. We need your robustness. Haribo Yogesh. Thank you, Yogesh. Karuna Sindhu, so sweet. Karunika, yesterday in the morning class you mentioned a topic about if we should take chocolate too. As the end of you mentioned at the end of life we have to answer Krishna, would you be please be able to elaborate on we answer to Krishna at the end of life? Well, if we are trying to go back to Godhead, right, we are facing Krishna. Yes. And of course, you know, if we have our impurities, yes, then we cannot enter into the spiritual world. So we must be able to go before Krishna, and so that he at least will reveal himself to us at the end of life, and that we will see him face to face. But even if we see him face to face, then still, you know, what is our level of purity? If we're not pure, then Krishna will may give us a glimpse and then disappear. Just like he did for Narada Muni, when Narada was the son of the maidservant and meditating under the tree, then he got a darshan of Krishna and Krishna only told him, that this life you will not see me anymore. And because he had to become more pure. So let us do what we can to become purified. Okay, Razika Roy. If one has an idea for a small social media project but feels like the desire for recognition and praise in driving him, how should we proceed? make the small social media project, and don't worry about praise and recognition, just make it. And even if you have some desires for praise, this, that, you know, will get purified later. But meanwhile, make the small social media project. Why not? And if you make it a little, if you make a little bigger social media project, that's also good. Because Prabhupada said, I have one problem, Prabhupada said. I can't think small. Prabhupada could only think big. Yeah. Merry Christmas, happy Gita Jayanti. Just finished Shri Upanishad for the second time and really feel a certain energy that's very powerful in those mantras and purpose that is different than the other Prabhupada's books I've read. Just finished the teaching of Lord Chaitanya 5 days back and then Shri Upanishad a couple of days ago. It almost felt like the writing was different in the purpose of the Upanishad, like very sharp. Felt a very strong connection to Shri Upanishad, powerful. Is there a reason I felt this way both times in reading Upanishad? Well, we may all have a particular book that touches us. So that is your personal nature, your personal state of mind, and so that's nice. You just stick with that and really read the Upanishad again and again and just go deeper into it. In my case, it's not the Upanishad. In my case, it's the Chaitanya Charitamrita. So that's the book. I can't get enough of it. And the second book is the Nectar of Devotion. Oh, no, it doesn't want to go down. Oh, yeah. Is the layer of illusory energy on the Dham influence of Yogamaya or Mahamaya? Yogamaya. It is Krishna's arrangement. Hare Krishna. Gurudev knows all the languages. No, Krishna knows all the languages. I just know a few. The bars of the prison is sex desire. Since these bars are connected to the body and mind, would it be true to say that unless one is completely transcendental to the body and mind, we can't penetrate these bars? Well, they're serious bars, and therefore there is a license in the Grihastha Ashram when we cannot immediately overcome these desires. But and we can take shelter of the Grihastha Ashram, and there sexual enjoyment is there's such a design by Krishna that lust turns into sacrifice once you have a child. So that is amazing. It starts with lust, then there's children, and then it becomes sacrifice. Guna Avatar wants to, what is this? Sadhana Siddha, not Sadhana Siddhi, but Sadhana Siddhi is a name of a person, and Sadhana Siddha is the perfection that is attained by, through practicing the process of devotional service. Kripa Siddha is the perfection that is attained through mercy. And Nitya Siddha is the person who came down from the spiritual world and was always perfect. In our case, in Lord Chaitanya's movement, we are attaining perfection in a combination of Sadhana Siddha and Kripa Siddha. Because these days and age in Kali Yuga, we are weak at sadhana. So if it depends on our effort in devotional service, we are weak and cannot do. Okay, Karuna Sindhu, okay. Ask your question and then I am going to take rest. Yes.
Gurudev?
Yes.
Well, Gurudev, You're speaking about how we have to face Krishna and in of our lives, but it makes me wonder, how does one who is in a position of eternal knowledge and bliss come down to the material world? What influences somebody who's on that platform of consciousness to degrade themselves by coming here? Is it out of curiosity, or, you know, not everybody that comes here is just coming here to fulfill Krishna's lila. So other people are coming here for their own material attachments. Okay. But how does one who's already in the spiritual world come down here?
The fall of the jiva. usually, I only answer that question on a rainy day. And it's been raining the whole week, and today the sun shined. What to do?
So Karuna, I just missed it.
You know, too bad, you know. Oh, dear Karuna. But I'm going to explain it to you one day, but not today. Oh, because this question is a bit... It's a question that's being brought up many times. But don't worry about it, Karuna. Somehow or other, we became captured by the material energy. We came a little too close to it, and then we became captured, and here we are. And now we are in this jail, and now we have to get out of here. Okay, so we'll talk about that when I have some more energy. I thank you all, and yes, we will see you all very soon. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.